Today I'm going to be demonstrating the type of applications you can build on the AppSmith platform. We're going to be building a recommendation manager. Recommendation managers are used to visualize the recommendations your users are served, and it gives you options to delete recommendations that don't make sense, as well as add new ones that you think are more appropriate. So let's begin by actually visualizing our user data that's there in our backend. To do this, we can go ahead and create an API that talks to our backend. Let's call it fetch users. And here I'm going to be using Postgres. So some of you may not be familiar with the syntax, but Postgres allows me to query the backend through an API-like format. So I can add a limit to this data because I know it's going to be a large data set. I will start the offset from zero. And I can also select certain columns such as ID, name, email, address, and the avatar. And let's also order this data by the ID. So now we want to actually visualize this information on our application. To do that, we can begin by creating a container. So containers are widgets that logically group other widgets. And we can name this container users. This property pane allows us to update the properties of all of our widgets and also provide some basic styling options. To visualize a list of users, we can use a table. So right now our table has some hard-coded information by default, but to get the data from the API into this table, it's as easy as using the mustache syntax and referencing the data using the name of the API followed by its data property. So just like that, we're able to visualize all the data that was there in our API. But this data set is typically a paginated data set. So we're going to go ahead and enable pagination here. And we're also going to say on page change, let's go ahead and call the fetch users API again. And let's now update our API to handle pagination. So our offset is right now hard-coded to zero, but to make sure the offset updates along with the page number, let's actually use the mustache syntax again and reference the table2.pageNumber property. Let's subtract one since page number starts from one, and let's multiply this by our limit. And just like that, we're able to actually iterate over our entire data set. But we don't just want to iterate over the data set, we also want to be able to search for particular users. Let's use this input as a search box. Let's call it search name. And let's say on text change, let's call the fetch users again. Let's once again update our API to now add the functionality to filter. Let's filter by name and let's use the I like property. And to this, we can pass the inputs text so that we filter by the name. Let's save this API. And just like that, we're able to filter our entire data set. Now let's also drill down on this data set. Suppose you want to drill down on this user and we want to display this user's image. Today is just an avatar URL. Let's use the image view for that. And since the data is there in the table, we can also reference the table's information and say table's selected row dot avatar. And like that, we have the table's avatar showing up here. So now any user we select, their information shows up. But we also want to populate the user's recommendations. So let's also set that on row selected, let's call the get recommendations API. And let's also display this information here in a table. But there's something wrong here. The products show as objects, probably because our data format shows all the products in a nested structure. But it's pretty easy to just go ahead and flatten it using a little JavaScript. That's where AppSmith becomes really handy, where you can just write JavaScript to kind of overcome any limitations you might see. So to flatten a data structure becomes as simple as writing a map function. And now we can actually add recommendations to this user's data. So let's go ahead and add this product. And just like that, the data shows over here. But we also want to be able to delete these recommendations. So let's add a column action. We can name it delete. And let's go ahead and call the delete API. On success, let's refresh the data by calling recommendations again. And just in case it errors out as well, let's just call recommendations as well. So just like that, we're also able to delete data from the data set. And now that we have this working in editor mode, we want to actually deploy this application for our users. So we can just publish this application. And we end up getting a full-fledged published application here. And here we can go ahead and delete our user recommendations, as well as add new recommendations to this user's data.